Good morning. Those of you who don't know me, my name is Linda Morey, and I'm the Music and Worship Director here at South Harbor Creek. I'm happy to be with you this morning while Pastor Keith takes a much-deserved break and spends some time with his family. When I was thinking about what I would share with you this morning, I wanted to share something that I know well, and music immediately came to mind. Life is a series of give and takes, ups and downs, famine and feast, want and plenty, good times and bad times, opposites. And we are experiencing some of those in our country today. For example, it's a beautiful day outside. The sun is shining, the skies are blue, the grass and the leaves of the trees are brilliantly green. And we thank God for his glorious creation and for his blessings that he gives us every day. And yet, in our country, we have political and racial tension and unrest. And in the world, we have the COVID-19 pandemic. Remembering to praise God in the good times is easy, but in times of strife, it becomes more difficult. And yet God asks that we praise him in all things and at all times. Thankfully, the Bible gives us several verses that I'm going to call even if verses. For example, today, even though we have strife and unrest and COVID-19 in our country, we can still praise God for his glorious creation and the blessings that he gives to us. In the book of Job, in chapter 13, verse 15, in the NIV version, we find this: though he slay me, yet will I hope in him. I will surely defend my ways to his face. Job was a man who had much suffering and tragedy in his life, and yet he chose to praise God even in the midst of it. Now, in case you don't use the word slay in your everyday vocabulary, the contemporary English version of the Bible says it this way: God may kill me, but still I trust him and offer my defense. Habakkuk 3 is another place where we can find praise of God in the hard times. Though the fig tree should not blossom, or even if the fig tree does not blossom, and there be no fruit on the vines, though the yield of the olive should fail, and the fields produce no food, though the flock should be cut off from the fold, and there be no cattle in the stalls, yet I will exalt the Lord. I will rejoice in God my salvation. One of my favorite praise songs is Blessed Be Your Name by Matt and Beth Redman. We sing it here a lot at South Harbor Creek Church, and I think that it's one of your favorites by which the enthusiasm that you sing it with. And it is full of even if verses. The first verse of the song says, "Blessed be your name in the land that is plentiful, where the streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name." Deuteronomy 8:10 aligns with this perfectly. When you have eaten and are satisfied, praise the Lord your God for the good land he has given you. The second verse of the song reads, "Blessed be your name when I'm found in the desert place. When I walk through the wilderness, blessed be your name." We can link this even if verse to the Habakkuk 3 verses we mentioned earlier, that even though the fig tree does not blossom and the yield of the olive should fail, still I will exalt your name. The third verse of the song reads, "Blessed be your name when the sun's shining down on me, when the world's all as it should be. Blessed be your name." Good times. James 1:17 says, "Every good thing given and every perfect gift is from above." The fourth verse is the even if verse. It reads, "Blessed be your name on the road marked with suffering, though there's pain in the offering. Blessed be your name." We turn to Psalms, where Psalm 42:5 says, "Why are you in despair, O my soul? For I shall again praise him for the help of his presence." So verse 1 and 3 are the positive verses, and verse 2 and 4 are times of suffering and struggle. Matt Redman continues this thought in the pre-chorus. "Every blessing you pour out, I'll turn back to praise." We can link to Deuteronomy 8:17 and 18. "Otherwise, you may say in your heart, my power and the strength of my hand made me this wealth. But you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who has given you the power to make wealth, that he may confirm his covenant which he swore to your fathers, as it is this day. And then the rest of the pre-chorus, the even if sentence, when the darkness closes in, Lord, still I will say, blessed be the name of the Lord, from Psalm 23, which you know well. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and staff comfort me. The bridge of the song, you give and take away, you give and take away. My heart will choose to say, Lord, blessed be your name. Again, in Job we find, naked I come from my mother's womb, and naked I shall return. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Even if we have struggles in our lives, God is always there for us. He will never desert us. There is nothing in heaven or earth or under the earth that can separate us from the love that is in Christ Jesus. Thank you, God. Finally, the chorus of the song we sing, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your name. The book of Daniel says, let the name of the God be praised forever and ever, for wisdom and power belong to him. And the remainder of the chorus, blessed be the name of the Lord, blessed be your glorious name, from Psalm 27, 18 and 19. Blessed be the Lord God, the God of Israel, who alone works wonders, and blessed be his glorious name forever. And may the whole earth be filled with his glory. Amen and amen. Friends, in these stressful times, we can stand with other fellow believers and give praise to our Heavenly Father for all his blessings to us. We can be reminded of their strength in high and low times and their faith of looking to God for everything and blessing his name. Now I know that you are just dying to sing this song, as am I. And so with Sue Fuller's help with the camera, please join us in singing Blessed Be Your Name.
Oh.
One last thing today. While I was researching this song, I came across something which I found very interesting that I will share with you. In the book of Psalms, there are several psalms that in verses 18 and 19 of each one, there are sentences that give us strength and hope in times of trouble. If you'd care to jot them down, I will give you the psalm numbers so that you may look them up and use them in your daily devotions. They are Psalms 33, 34, 37, 68, I'm sorry, 66, 71, 84, and 94. And in case you were getting your pencil or a piece of paper, I will share them with you again. Psalm 33, 34, 37, 51, 66, 71, 84, and 94. Verses 18 and 19 in all of them. Let us pray. Lord God, we bless your glorious name. We recognize you as sovereign. And even if our walk is difficult at this time, we turn our eyes on you and take hope in your word and promises. I ask that you be with each person listening today, and thank you for this time we've spent together here. May your word bless us throughout the remainder of the day. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank you, and have a glorious day.